guys, you know, like, this is what y'all pledge allegiance to. You know, I would get made fun of. You know, when I was in high school, I was learning about Obama, you know, increasing drone strikes in the country. You know, that pissed me off because, like, you know, Obama, you know, I do not like Obama, you know, because he bombed the shit out of my people. You know what I'm saying? And I would sit down for the Pledge of Allegiance, and all the honors kids sitting around me would be like, oh, how can you? It's America. Like, we're the number one country. It's you. Like, it's the number one country. Bombing my people. Like, standing up for. You know, a teacher can get mad at teacher that I asked at the beginning of class, you know, I asked this teacher, do I need to read the Bible to succeed in your class? Because this is an English class, you know what I mean?
All right, this fella has a mixed bag, obviously. This is in Metro Atlanta, okay? There's more, but let me remind everyone, this is a high school. This is a substitute teacher, okay? This is a junior that said, Tyler Rambush said, Centennial High School junior said, the environment was unhealthy, is what the student said. I don't think someone like that should be allowed in a classroom setting. He decided to compare Obama to Hitler and call someone the C word in school, he explained. The vice president of the NAACP is still concerned about the impact the teacher caused on students. NAACP says, and I quote, it's very disturbing the kind of language that was being used in the classroom, said Gerald Griggs. And we've had Gerald Griggs on the show before. First vice president of the Atlanta NAACP. School is not the place to have that kind of virtual conversation with young people. That's why we're concerned. And the definite racist overtones that were coming out were very, very concerning. The district immediately fired the teacher and reported him to human relations. In a statement, the school's principal said, and I quote, we expect all members of our school community, student and adults alike, to treat others with dignity and respect differing viewpoints and opinions. So listen, I highlight this to you because this is one of those things that's a real thing. Critical race theory is not a real thing, even though legislation will get passed saying you gotta stop teaching critical race theory, not even taught in K-12 education. It's a big nothing burger, right? It's a distraction. But this does happen where you have miseducation, egregious education, and individuals who are racially and otherwise insensitive to the culture of the student. Now, the students were universally offended based on the reporting here, okay? But they were in a situation where this is the teacher. What are you going to do? It's the teacher saying these things. Now, you may actually agree with some of the things the teacher said. That's not the conversation here. The issue is, was it appropriate for this to be said to students in an actual classroom setting? That's your issue. All right, Kyla, thoughts here?
Yeah, no, that teacher was completely inappropriate and out of line with how they addressed and talked to the students. And it's really unfortunate because he could have actually had an opportunity to give students a nuanced discussion about neoliberalism, right, why they should be anti-war, or their failings of democratic leaders. I wouldn't call Obama Hitler, but he's certainly a war criminal like dozens of other presidents are. And so that point was all lost because he wanted to show his behind and curse and use other overtones when there is a appropriate way to have a discussion. And so that teacher definitely lost a lot of, you know, a great opportunity to teach the students something.
I so agree with you on that. It is not just about how the plane takes off, it's also about how you landed. And sometimes people are concerned about one and not the other. You gotta do both, right? I actually had the privilege of lecturing at St. Petersburg College today in Florida. And I was lecturing the professorial staff. And we had over 100 professors. I lectured them for about 2 hours today. And the lecture was about equity in education, equity in education. And one of the questions at the end of the lecture was about how do we talk about policy to our students without getting involved in the politics of Florida? Because Florida, they have their own brand of crazy politics right now. And I said, you have to lead with the policy aspect and how that policy impacts people. Now you can disconnect the personality and the politics, but talk directly about the policy. And that's how you take the plane from runway, flight, and land it again. And this educator obviously did not understand that art, which means maybe education inside of a classroom with children, is not for you.